Thanks, Kent. Here we are about 23 hours away from tip-off tomorrow, 12 noon with South Carolina coming to town. Quick preview, I think coming off a really good road win against Ole Miss. Played really well in a game at home against Arkansas where they had the lead there with less than a minute to go. You look at from a personnel standpoint, really effective from three-point range, especially here late. Chico Carter, who I believe is leading the SEC. Michi Johnson, who has been shooting it at a high clip. And then Jacoby Wright up front, Josh Gray, you know, five offensive rebounds a game over their last five games. And then Hayden Brown, who I think is one of the hardest playing guys in our league. And then, of course, G.G. Jackson, who's a top 15 NBA pick in the upcoming draft. So I know our players worked extremely hard yesterday in practice and looking forward to the opportunity tomorrow afternoon.
Obviously, you almost – I mean, you came close Wednesday, Tuesday night. How did the team respond to that yesterday in practice? And, you know, kind of have you seen, like, a renewed response from
Sure. I thought it responded well. Practice was good. Obviously, there's great disappointment from the game on Tuesday. I thought we played extremely hard. Unfortunately, I thought a lot of missed opportunities due to turnovers and so forth. But, no, I thought the guys have stayed the course through some challenging times, come to practice to get better and find ways to try to win the next game. I know we've talked about it. I think you're battling human nature a little bit, just psychology of sport. You know, been fortunate in the last four full seasons of college basketball, been a part of double-digit win streaks. Now on the other side of that, and, you know, the approach is always, you know, to have the mindset to move on and focus on the next most important thing, which is trying to win the next game, whether you're winning or you're losing. I think it's obviously easier when you're winning, but I think that's what we're battling, and I think our players responded well in practice this week, and I know they're looking forward to the opportunity tomorrow.
Yeah, KJ seemed to get back on track a little bit earlier this week. Just what was the difference, I guess, between this game and maybe a couple of the games prior?
I thought his physicality in the post to create those passing angles, I thought we did a better job of getting the ball to him there. He didn't convert on a couple of them, but I thought he did a nice job there when we had him and Sean Phillips in the game at the end of the first half, and he was playing more on the perimeter, drove it down the middle of the lane. A couple little mid-range floaters there we didn't convert on, but I thought they were nice plays. And then, you know, just from an execution standpoint, I thought his post-ups happened with him having a piece of the paint versus out at 15 to 17 feet where – you know, guards can come and dig the ball out of the post, or the double team is more effective. So, you know, I thought he had a much more concerted effort to establish himself inside, as was evidenced. I believe only took one three in the game, and the rest of his work was done in the painted area.
Yeah, Coach. Cam Hayes obviously has had, I mean, an up and down season where he came in and emerged as a starter. Just how have you seen him try to continue to grow coming off, I mean, as in his third year in college? Just what have you seen from him with the ups and downs of this year?
Well, I think his improvement has been made as you look at the summer and fall, and then, you know, as he worked his way into the lineup through efficient offensive play, limiting turnovers, taking higher percentage shots. I think he's a very good shooter, and he's been very efficient because of that. I think his on-ball defense has been very solid on the perimeter. But when you go through the numbers, I mean, he's clearly been our most efficient guard from an offensive standpoint. So I think some of that is having a lower turnover rate, and some of that is taking higher percentage shots and stepping up and knocking some of those down.
Your rebounding has improved dramatically, I guess, the last four, five, six games. Is that strictly the three freshmen are really hitting the boards really well, or is everybody kind of doing their job?
I think everybody, but the three freshmen, you know, as you see, all have the size and length for the position at this level. So I think that has helped. You saw Sean Phillips get seven rebounds in 11 minutes on Tuesday night. Jalen got six rebounds. I think Tyrell has helped some of our perimeter rebounding. You know, the defensive glass has been improved for us. Offensively, I think it needs to continue to be an area of focus for us because, as you've seen, plenty of opportunities for us to go and get some offensive rebounds with our inefficient shooting from the floor.
Yeah, I guess this was like the first time maybe in a couple months that we've seen you guys in a really tight situation late in the game. Just how do you think the guys responded to that? Obviously taking the lead with KJ's bucket, but then giving it up there right after. Just how did you guys think you did there?
Yeah, I think a mixed bag, Glenn. We look at those situations. I know you and I have talked about this before, kind of similar to football, that those are the special teams aspect of the game. And, you know, we had a lot of success there early in the season in some of those situations. Obviously, the other night was a mixed bag. I thought the execution on the play to get KJ the score was really well done by all five players on the floor. You know, it's my responsibility at the end of game to make sure we're in the right spots. On the last drive, we got beat off the dribble. We did not have gap discipline on the ball side. They were overloaded, and we did not cover it well. KJ made a big-time play to come over and contest with verticality, and Hill made a really difficult shot off almost the top of the glass. But, that's my responsibility to make sure we execute better. As I kind of charted as we go through the season, always trying to get better. I think in my eyes, been in those situations 8 times, kind of a 50-50 game down the stretch. You look at the Wake Forest game, executed really well on both ends of the floor in those special team situations to win it. Arlington, ETSU, and I believe Wofford were games we needed runs late to win. And then Arkansas at home, execution wasn't perfect, but did enough to get the win there. But then you look, the end of the Kansas State game, we did not finish the play in time after review, and then late against Kentucky, we're unable to get a good look at a three to tie, and then, wish we could have gotten a better look there or a defensive stop to win the game. So that's my responsibility, and we got to do a better job there.
Hey, Coach, with Sean Phillips, how much does it help just having a guy on the floor who's just a real threat on that pick and roll for in terms of the lob? How much does he sort of open up the offense by just being that like sort of rim attacking threat through the air?
It's a really good question, and I think it's something we need to take advantage of more. We missed him on 3 wide open lobs in those type of settings in Tuesday night's game where we did not make the right read because of his size. A lot of 7-footers, stiff, can't move. He has really good agility and mobility for his size. And so I think you've seen him be able to help with our paint defense, both protecting the rim with his ability to contest shots, and then, as I mentioned, the defensive rebounding, 7 rebounds in just 11 minutes on Tuesday. Now the next step is for us to do a better job of getting him opportunities at the rim, whether that's in ball screen and roll situations or transition opportunities to get him some easy baskets down there.
Yeah, Coach, 19 turnovers against Georgia. I guess how frustrating is it to still see this much carelessness with the basketball this late in the season?
Yeah, it's very disappointing. Very disappointing. Again, it's my responsibility. Ball security is my responsibility. And we threw 5 passes to the people sitting in the courtside seats on Tuesday night. I mean, it's just wasted possessions, really disappointing. And it's, at the end of the day, it's the difference in winning and losing. We're really big on the value of every possession. So we might look at and say, if we could have gotten that one stop at the end of the game, you win the game. But then you look at 19 turnovers. 19 times we don't even get a shot at the basket. If you cut those in half and just go 3 for 9 from the floor on those additional possessions, that's 6-7 extra points. So, sometimes there's credit to the defense. Georgia did have 8 steals. Credit to them on that. But then you look at the other ones, just simple fundamental basketball, passing, catching, dribbling. We have to do a much better job there.
We haven't talked about him all year, but Cornelius Williams, is there an update on just how he's doing? And obviously, redshirt year for him, but how he's coming
Yeah, back? he's been out with a shoulder injury, so just is doing his medical redshirt as he gets back from that.
Yeah, and this has obviously been a really tough stretch for everyone, but just I'm curious if you've had any talks with any of your former mentors or anybody around LSU or the program or anything about just how to get through this just from you personally?
Yeah, without getting into the specifics, I mean, I think that's what you really appreciate, not just as a coach, but just as a person, you know, when things aren't going the way you would like them to do, when you're falling short of your expectations and standards, that you have people in your corner that are there to support and encourage you, give some wisdom and advice and try to learn from the experience. You know, I don't want this to be a wasted 7 weeks. I've learned a lot from it individually. I've learned a lot about our team, you know, learned things I want to do differently moving forward, things we can do better, so on and so forth. So you know, I'm really appreciative of that. I've got you know former coaches of mine, family, great fans here, you know, that have reached out in great support, and I appreciate that. I'm thankful for that. You know, I'm also thankful for the criticism. I think you know you don't ever want to be a place where losing is okay, or not playing up to your standard is okay. So I think that's just part of college athletics. But you know, certainly I'm very appreciative to have really good people that have been very supportive of me.